Hi, my name is Ir01. I'm from Horizon Development Team, and in this video I'm gonna show you how you can set up a new project or implement an existing project for Inner Core. So the first thing you're gonna need is to install all the requirements. The video about it is in the description. So the next thing we're gonna need is to go to the Inner Core mod toolchain. The link is also under the video, and open the file called toolchainsetup.py. So the first thing we're gonna try is to create a new mod. We copy the contents of the file and create a new file here, text document, and I'll call it toolchain setup.py, not to confuse myself later. And I just paste the contents I have just copied recently. And I close the file. Another option is just to go to core mod toolchain, download the whole zip archive, and get the file from the archive. But this one is a bit faster. And also I will copy the import script as well, so that I do not need to run it to create it manually later. Toolchain import .py. Also open with a code editor. In this case it is Visual Studio Code, but you can do it also in the Notepad or some other code editor, but I would recommend just using Visual Studio Code because it is more convenient for different tasks, and also it is used in Inner Core mod toolchain. So let's switch to our directory. The next thing we're gonna need is to run the command prompt. We press WinR, type CMD, and press Enter. So as you can see, we are in the local drive C currently, and the drive we haven't packed the folder into is D. So to change our drive, we type D and the column, and just press Enter. This makes you jump to the D drive, and then you copy the path from here. Just Control C to copy the path. Here we type cd, change directory, and in the quotes, double quotes, we type the directory, Control V to paste it. So we are in the directory called mods, and now we are going to create a new mod environment. So to do that, we type Python. If you were following the instruction from the previous video, you will have the valid Python installation, and thus you can type Python toolchain setup.py. I use tab to allow the command prompt to hint the script name for me. Toolchain setup.py requires one parameter, and this is the folder where you want to create a mod. I will create a folder called test mod, and if you are using folder name with space, you should also use double quotes, but I prefer not to do so. And if you do not want to specify the folder here, you can just optionally create a new folder, some folder, copy this setup script to some, copy this setup script to this folder and run from here. So if no directory is specified, this script runs in the current directory, but I will create the project in the new directory called test mod. So the next thing this script will do is downloading the archive of the toolchain from here, and unpack it. So when it's done, we will return to the video. Okay, so it is already extracted. I didn't expect it was so fast. So it has extracted the toolchain to our directory. We can go to this directory to verify what is here. And then it runs another Python script that wants to set up the initial project values. For example, the project name, we will call it test mod, and this is the string that will be displayed in the mod info, in for example, in the mod browser, to specify the name of the mod. The next thing we're gonna type is the author name. I will type my name, x01. Then project version is 1.0 by default, and we will leave it as is. And project description, we will leave it empty, just because it's a test mod and it doesn't require a description. Do you want to initialize a new native directory? Here we will initialize a new empty directory, native directory, sorry, so that we can verify everything about native modding. We should enter the native module name. This module can be called something like test module. You can also skip, just press enter, and the default value sample will be used. So we will call it test module. And we will also initialize a new Java directory with the same, no, not with the same, but with the test Java, I think, name. Do you want to clean up the project? Cleaning up the project means just deleting toolchain.zip and some other stuff that is not used after the installation, after the unpacking, after verifying everything. And yes, we want to clean up the project. We can just leave it empty because yes is the default value. So project is successfully set up, and we can go to the folder. Here it is, test mod, create a newly created folder. And here you can see there are a lot of files. But the thing we're gonna do is we're gonna right click the folder and press the open with code button. This will open this folder as a Visual Studio Code project, workspace. Another way, if you don't have the open with code option in the context menu, you just open the new window. And in this new window, you press File, Open Folder, and select your test mod folder as the folder you want to open. This is the project structure itself. As you can see, not all the directories and files are displayed here. It's okay. It's just not to confuse you with a lot of files. So the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna check out the Java source code. As you can see, there's a sample logger output here. And also there's a native part where there are a lot of code, there is a lot of code. I think it will be removed in the future, but currently there are just some hints, just some examples of what you can do with native code. And as you can see, the imports are highlighted with red. So the plugins we installed in the previous video didn't find the used libraries. To resolve this issue, we should run build task for native directory. To do so, we press Ctrl, Shift, and B. And here you can see some options for building. So we will use build and push everything. And as you can see, there are a lot of things happening. And it will take some time to prepare the native development kit toolchain. That's because this toolchain uses an NDK, a local NDK installation. That means that it copies files from the NDK we set up yesterday, so in the previous video, yeah, and makes a standalone installation that can be used, doesn't matter on what machine you use it. So while it is building, I'll just discuss with you the other options for build. So the options are build and push everything, builds and push everything in the project, yeah? So it builds all the assets, scripts, JavaScript scripts, also Java files and native modules. Assemble mod for release builds a new icmod file, so the archive where the mod is stored, and you can just take it and publish on the Unicode website. Another option is build and push Java. This only builds and pushes to the remote device the Java files. So if you are changing only Java code, you should run this task. There is also an option build and push native. The same thing as with Java, but with C++ code. Building scripts and resources, build scripts and assets so that you can use this task if you need to push your scripts, JavaScript files. And finally, clean up is just a task that cleans everything up, makes removes all build files. Let's say so. So, as you can see, the installation was successful only from the second attempt. That's okay, that happens. And after that, it compiled all the C++ code, then ran the Gradle Java build. And if you have your device connected to the computer, via USB cable, it is able to push everything and even run Horizon application on your mobile phone. After that, we will restart our Visual Studio Code. Here it is, test mode. And as you can see, the imports are resolved. It will take a couple of minutes for it to resolve everything, but as you can see, everything is resolved and the headers are not highlighted, so here you can just go and type your C++ native code. So that's all for setting up a new project, and the next thing we're going to discuss is how to import an existing project. So for this purpose, I use my thirst mod. It is a mod by Mind Programming, which adds a thirst to the game. It's quite a simple mod, but it's okay to demonstrate you how it works, actually. So there are some folders here. There is a build config file in the mod, and that's the file that will be used to build a new file structure. So be sure that it is located in the folder you are going to specify, and we'll use the toolchain import script. And this time I'm gonna copy it to this thirst mod folder just to demonstrate you how it works. Let's type cd thirst mod. So we are switching to the thirst mod directory, and we type python toolchain import.py. And if we are working in the current directory, we do not need to specify the paths to the directory. So if this script was here, if we were running it from here, we had to specify the path to the directory. If we are in the directory, we don't need to do so. Just press enter. So the first thing that is happening is backing up project to the project.back folder. So this is just copying everything that was in the original project to the project.back directory so that it isn't corrupt or something like that. So if you have tested the newly created project and it's okay, only then you remove the project back folder. Also, you can add it to the gitignore files and leave it as is in case something goes wrong one more time. Okay, so it has downloaded the toolchain archive and extracted it to this directory. Then it runs the import script, and this import script imports the build config from the project back, mod info, and copies everything that should be copied from here to the new project structure. And then it asks us the same question as it used to ask in the previous example with the new mod. So we don't want to need to initialize a new native directory, and we don't need to initialize a new Java directory, and we want to clean up the project. So project successfully imported. Please delete the project backed after triple checking that everything is okay. So we will open it with code, and this time we're gonna see this mod is quite unusual one. The main file contains only one import, and the other logic is in this third lib. But here we can just verify that you have some facilities to develop your mods. For example, if I start to type dimensions, it's a new module that is used to create dimensions. You can see that you have all the hints. So that you can create a new dimension like this, custom dimension, and here you can see also all the parameters, etc. And also we can verify that the Java default namespaces are also here. For example, Java util random, so you can create it just like this. So the hints work for Java code as well. That's because the GNI libs folder is here. Another thing we should discuss is how you can update these hints. So all you need to do is go to your Unicode mod toolchain folder, go to toolchain mod, toolchain, JS libs, and download these three libraries and unpack them here. Like this, you can update the hints if the documentation was updated by us, by the developer team. That's all for today. Thank you for being with me for so long, and to the next video. Thank you.